Thank you for joining us today. I'm Rudy Stebby, and welcome to Episode 18, First Looks at IE10, here on HelpDesk TV. On April 12th, Microsoft released the first platform preview for Internet Explorer 10. In this video, we will show you some new features included with this release, including CSS3 gradients, multi-column, flexible box, and grid layouts. With CSS3 gradients, you can now use standard HTML markup to achieve visual effects in which previously you could only achieve using graphic editing programs. In this demo, you are able to make different kinds of gradient backgrounds. You have the choice of changing colors, as well as changing the gradient style from linear to circular to elliptical. Scrolling down the page allows you to see the CSS3 markup for different browsers. Here's a look at the CSS3 multi-column layout as used to show the top tweets streaming in from Twitter. Here, I will add some tweets. As the top tweets come in, you will see them flow across the columns. You can change the number of columns, and as you will notice, the tweets reflow. Now, let's look at this in another browser. Here is the same demo using the same markup in Firefox 4. You'll notice as the tweets come in and flow across the columns, you'll see that some of them are clipped or cut off, causing for an imperfect user experience. And finally, let's look at one more example. Here, we show you how fully accelerated graphics and fast JavaScript is used to create lifelike experiences. Here, I have 250 fish swimming at a nice steady frame rate. Take note that the size of your screen will directly affect the frame rate. Now let's look at how the scene is composed. First, high definition HTML5 video for the water. Then, we use the canvas to frame and shape the fishbowl. Now, we add composition effects for the visual of the glass bowl. Here's the shine, front of the fishbowl, and the shadow. Now the HTML5 audio for the sound. And now finally, the fish swimming. Let's try this in another browser. Here in Chrome 11, you have the same demo running the same markup. Now let's add the same 250 fish. You will now notice the animation and rendering is now slower. This is the difference between full and partial hardware acceleration in the browser. I hope you enjoy today's HelpDesk TV. If you have a comment about this program, a question, or a shortcut you'd like to share with me, send us an email message to feedback@helpdesktv.ca. Thanks for watching.